What's going on? I'm Marcus Fly. We're here at the Ricardo Montalban Theater for the Ya Tú Sabes. This is the Monologue Fest. You don't want to miss a thing. It's going to be huge. We're going to catch all the writers and the creators and the amazing process that they go through to make this happen.
So yeah, so through nosotros, we created a program called Ya Tú Sabes, which is initially started off as an underground monologue slam. We wanted to create something that was different from the typical showcases that a lot of the organizations do for, let's say, the streamers or for the studios. We wanted something more with a lively feel, more upbeat, more interactive. So in our collaboration with NBC Universal, we established the Ya Tú Sabes Monologue Slam, which is basically a program where we open it up nationwide, now worldwide, to unique Latino voices, whether they are starting out or established, to submit a 2 to 3 minute monologue.
Juan Munivar, the creative director for Nosotros.
Amazing. How did this all come about?
Well, basically, we wanted to showcase rising Latin talents. We think that there is an extremely important hole that we need to fill. People need to understand that representation matters, and this is exactly what we did. We set up writers, wrote the monologues, Latinx actors acted the monologues, and the whole production team was Hispanic. So this is a complete and total showcase of what we as a community have to offer.
I just want to see people perform. I love seeing people perform. I'm excited.
We're incredibly excited. You know, NBC Universal has been a longtime champion of diverse storytellers, and tonight we get to see those people on stage. So we're always happy to support and see what talent is out there and what we can do in the future to collaborate.
Yes, my monologue is called The First Breakfast, and it's kind of like a love letter to my dad. And our relationship is very layered but beautiful at the same time. And I opened up my heart and sat down and just wrote whatever it is that was inside, and I hope it turns out well.
It's so special for me because when I came to LA from Chicago as a Cuban American, I was an actress, and Nosotros really helped me get involved with the Latino community and the industry, and now as a manager and producer, I'm happy to give back. And it's been very, very apparent to all of us. One of the huge reasons why we're here is because representation matters so much.
I think the Latin American community, like, we have a huge impact on Hollywood. We make 20% of the box office. We are such a big part of the country, but specifically Hollywood, and like, we are not represented in the way that we should be. So this event and these kind of things is fantastic because we get to be seen by our own people, being brought up by our own people in this industry, and then, you know, now we have an impact and we get to start telling our own stories in a bigger way.
Okay. Hey, my name is Mark Marquez. Chilling. It's crazy for me. It's important for me because I get to be with a lot of like Latinx writers, a lot of Latinx actors. This is my first time, my writing being kind of recognized, so it's really kind of first, and it's really cool. It's pretty cool.
This is totally like grassroots. Like, let's dig it out the mud and let's make it happen, and make sure that no stone is unturned. We're gonna define what it takes to be a breakout, and tonight is the night. So we're here to make sure everybody knows about it. Well, number one, you belong. It's your turn. Come claim it. We're waiting for you. So do it for yourself. Do it for everyone that didn't get their chance when they had the goods and everyone slammed the doors on them. This door is open, so run through it. That's what I say.
It is important for all of us to find spaces where we can thrive and create. And I love this program in particular because I'm myself an actress, and I wish I had an opportunity like this at the beginning, you know? It's such a platform for them to portray and to show their talent and in front of so many important people that might open other opportunities for them. So I'm just thrilled for all the finalists. I can't wait to see them.
Just celebrating with all my other colleagues and tonight in Seattle, it all just came out. We're here to support each other, so that's the most important thing for me.
My name is Juan Hernandez.
Yes.
I'm one of the actor finalists in tonight's event, so yeah, that's what brought me out. Yeah. Honestly, it was Nosotros sent us a list of monologues. It was a couple of days of going through all 24 of them, and I found one that just really stuck out to me, and put a self-tape together just like I would any other audition. And sure enough, a couple months later, they reached out to me and said, "You're an actor finalist. Congratulations."
You know, I'm one of the finalist actors here for the Nosotros Ya Tu Sabes monologue competition. Very excited to see how this goes. Yeah. I'm over the moon, just giddy, waiting to see how this is going to turn out. I have no doubt it's going to be absolutely fantastic. Now I'm just excited to get inside and watch.
Hey, how are you doing? My name is Marco Parra. Hey, can you roll it? Can you roll it R's? Then roll those R's, man. What's important about tonight's event, I'm here to represent and to support everybody that's a part of Nosotros. I've been a part of a lot of their programs and been to a lot of their events. And what's so great about Nosotros is how they uplift the community and create opportunities for us Latinos to excel in the entertainment industry. And we don't have a lot of that, so we got to come out here and support these actors that are and the writers that are a part of this Ya Tu Sabes Monologue Slam, you know? They're up next, so we out here to support.
I would say create your own work. There's not enough space in this industry, or there is space in this industry for women of color, but you just have to be able to create that space for yourself. Yeah.
Take that first step. That's the hardest thing, is showing up. And, you know, be brave, don't worry about it. The first thing you do might not be the best, but that's okay, at least you did it. And that's the first step in getting going.
I was writing a day in August, and I thought this was good enough to submit. I submitted, and I was a writer's finalist. I would say, don't listen to those people that tell you you can't do it, because so many people told me I couldn't, and here I am.
How great it is. Do you understand how to do monologues? I'm going to learn a little bit more right now. I'm going to go inside the Ricardo Montalban Theater and check this out. Hope you guys have had a good time. It's been a whole lot of fun. We'll see you again.